Before, observe 1 minute silence in memory of the late Sri P.K. Vasudevan Nair, former Chief Minister of Kerala. All I request at this time. Thank you, sir. Honorable Home Minister of the Indian Union, Sri Sivaraj Patil. Respected Director of Police, Sri Raman Srivastava. My colleague, Sri Madhagar. Invited guests, members of the press, dear fellow staff members of the Academy, trainees of the Academy. Today, we meet under a pall of gloom caused by the demise of our former Chief Minister. Had it not been for that unfortunate event, this occasion would have been full of colour and pageantry as the occasion rightfully demands. It is not every day that the Home Minister of the Indian Union visits a state police training institution. I do not think that the large majority of institutions spread across the length and breadth of this country ever had the privilege of welcoming the Union Home Minister. We are indeed among the privileged few who have this opportunity. And truly, this is a red letter day. A day which will be remembered for long in the history of this institution. This is no occasion for a formal speech, even of welcome, because we are gathered just to listen to the Honorable Home Minister addressing the trainees. About the Academy, the detailed presentation has been made before the Honorable Home Minister, so I don't propose to say anything more on this issue. I will confine myself to welcoming Sri Sivaraj Patil because he would have spent much more time with us. He had agreed to spend the whole day from 11:00 hours, 17 hours in this academy, be a part of the passing out parade of the last batch of women police constables who are passing out on behalf of this academy, on behalf of health. Of the Kerala Police, on behalf of Kerala Police, on behalf of the Government of Kerala, I have the proud privilege to thank Mr. Sivaraj Patil for having consented to visit this institution, for having consented to take celebrate the passing out parade, to be our honored guest in this academy, and also for having consented to deliver this address to the trainees. On behalf of all of you, I am proudly privileged. Welcome, Sri Sivaraj Patil, to our midst. Thank you, sir. It's not proper to visit, to welcome the Director of Police. Still, for the sake of formality, I have great pleasure in welcoming Sri Raman Srivastava, the Director of Police, Kerala, to this academy. I now invite the Honorable Home Minister of the Indian Union, Sri Sivaraj Patil, deliver his address. Thank you.
Sri Raman Srivastava, Director General Police Kerala. Joker, the Lord, and in additional Director General for his training. Kerala. Other officer friends and clear trainings. I would also like to join Mr. Jacob and you all here in paying tribute the memory of your former Chief Minister, Mr. P.K. Vasudevan Nair, on the sad demise of his, which took place 2 days ago. Mr. Nair was a very upright politician and very good human being. I had the occasion to travel abroad in his company to attend one of the international conferences. Since that time, I had the occasion to meet him, to discuss certain political issues and certain other kinds of issues also. Every time I met him, I developed greater respect for his understanding and his uprightness. We would like to follow the principles which he observed in politics and in governance in all parts of our country. Well, this academy of yours is a new institution which is coming up in Kerala. We have some training institutions in India, but I think this academy of yours is one of the best training institutions that we have in the country. And it seems that the leaders in your state and the ministers in the government and the officers who are given this responsibility for building this institution have put their heart in it. And that is why it is taking a very, very good shape. One of the most important things is that it has a lot of land which is required. Generally, the universities and national laboratories and academies of this nature are tried to be built on smaller pieces of land. And once we do that, the scope for expansion becomes limited. But fortunately, those who have been responsible for visualizing the establishment of this academy have very rightly realized that academies naturally in Kerala you have a lot of greenery and a lot of water which is available here also, which is going to add to the pure environment and beauty of this place. I had the occasion to see some of the structures which have been put up here. I think the work is being done in an imaginary manner, in a manner which can meet your requirements in the future. The quality of work also appears to be quite good. For all these things, allow me to congratulate the Director General of Police Training, who is responsible for this, his senior colleague, Director General, and the Government of Kerala also, for establishing this institution in the country. I was told that it would be possible for this academy to train the officers and men in the paramilitary forces also. And that is one of the difficulties we at the national level are facing. We are going to have nearly 300 battalions of paramilitary forces in a few years to come. Government has agreed to give the funds for these purposes. But at times we are told that the training facilities which are required for this purpose are not available in adequate measure at the national level. I have no doubt in my mind that the facilities which are available in your academy will be used by paramilitary forces. That would give some more income, some more money to the academy, and that would give good facilities to the paramilitary forces to train their men and officers. I am indeed very happy to see, sitting on the benches in front of me, many ladies and women taking part in the training. Well, it has not been possible for the parliament and the legislative assemblies to give 33% reservation to the ladies in the legislatures. But probably here you are trying to make up that lacuna by allowing any ladies and women and girls joining the police force and taking up the responsibility of protecting the country's sovereignty, internal security and law and order. This is something we should be continuing. And I think if some more facilities are required to be given to the women police, there should be no hesitation and difficulty in giving more facilities to the women trainees who are coming for and very boldly coming for and taking part in the policing activity of our country. And the men and gentlemen need not feel dejected. I think you will also get the same facilities if are given to the women trainees as the women trainees would be getting. What is the kind of training which is required to be given? men in uniform have to learn. The first thing they are expected to do is to maintain law and order and discipline in the country. And this cannot be done without being disciplined yourself. Once I was asked by a friend of mine as to how I used to control the parliament, because you know I work as a speaker of the parliament, Lok Sabha, for some time. And they wanted to know as to how I control the unruly members in the parliament. I said, I did not control them. I controlled myself and they themselves got control. I had to tell them that when I felt ruffled and angry with them, it was not possible for me to maintain discipline in the house. But when I found that I was fully in control of myself, it was very easy for me to see that the order was established in the house, and even the learned and very senior members could take the orders from the chair. I think the same principle applies to you also. If you are disciplined in your life, if you are following the law very correctly, if you are trying to be just to anybody who is coming to you, it will not be difficult for you to discipline others, to protect law and order in your area, and to do justice to them. But it has to be started with the person who is going to dispense these things to others. And if it is not done, well, the others, under pressure or because you have the authority and the force, may follow what you are asking them to do, and yet you will find that that kind of cooperation was given to you, not fully, willingly, but with reluctance. So the discipline forces, the uniform forces, have to be themselves disciplined. And if they are not disciplined, it will be difficult for them to discipline others. The second thing which has to be done is to control the unruly elements in the society. That is what is meant by maintaining law and order in the system. You will be required to use the force which is available with you to control others. And if you use the force without applying your mind whether the quantum of force used by you is more than required or less than required, probably using the force will not also fully help you. You should know how and how much of the force has to be used in order to control the unruly elements which you are expected to control on occasions. So the judgment to use the force in proper manner is most important. If you do it every now and then without paying attention to the fact whether it is required or not, simply because it is available with you, that weapon of yours will get bloodied. And after some time you will find that that force is also not useful. So the strong people, strong countries, or strong men do not always use force. They use their determination and their wisdom to bring about a situation. situation in which things are done in a proper manner, rather than using the force which is available. This is something which has to be understood by our police force. While the presentation was given to us, I think in one of the slides it was shown that you have to deal with people with compassion as well as determination. In Hindi, I think it was in Sanskrit,
Mrudu Bhave.
And Mrudu Bhave Dhrudha Prati. Now this is what was written there on the slide. Mrudu Bhave means with compassion. You deal with those people with whom you have to bring to behave properly with compassion. Without understanding as to why he is behaving like that, you won't be effective. But at the same time, Mrudu Bhave Dhrudha Prati. But you have to do it with determination. Now these two words are really very important. And if you understand the meaning and the essence of these two words, compassion and determination, with which you have to deal with the situations and the human beings, in order to maintain law and order in the society, in order to protect the innocent people's lives and liberties and property, you will succeed. And this is something, this quality, you may not get it from the books only, or not only in the classroom. But if you ponder over your own duties, I think you will be able to understand the meaning of compassion, behaving with the people with whom you are expected to deal with compassion and determination. I have no doubt that you will do that. In the present times, you are likely to need modern weapons. And sometimes we are told that the terrorists are having modern weapons, whereas the policemen and the police officers do not have the same kinds of weapons, other equipment. Modern weapons, modern transport facilities, modern communication facilities are not available. May I tell you that maybe some people who are involved in terrorist activities may be having, some of them may be having better weapons and better transport facilities and communication facilities. And yet, all of them are not having better weapons or transport or communication facilities than you have. So don't be carried away by the discussion that they have better weapons than you. If you take into account the totality, you will find that you are having better weapons, better transport and equipment facilities. And I will assure you, on behalf of the Government of India, we need to give you better equipments, better transport and better communication facilities and all other things which are required by you to cope up with the modern demand. We have a plan which we are implementing to modernize our state police or paramilitary forces as well as our armed forces also. And this task of modernizing the armed forces in our country will not be stopped, because the question of modernizing these forces, it's not a one-time affair, but it is a continuing process. It will be there, and you will, as time passes, get better uniform, better protective care, better equipments, better transport facilities, armored vehicles, better communication facilities, not the old communication facilities, the most modern communication facilities. Maybe you will get the air cover also, which is required sometimes. Maybe you will get the boats and equipments like that, which will be required to protect the law and order on the coast and in the areas where the water is there and you have to move in the rivers and in these areas. This is the plan of the Government of India, and we will certainly do that. Please, don't be worried about it. In modern times, you are going to deal with the crime and the offenses which are going to be completely different. The intellectual offenses you will be required to deal with, and they are going to be more dangerous. But the cyber crime is something in which you have to equip yourself to deal with that. To commit crimes, people are likely to use not only the explosives, but they are likely to use many other things. Now they are talking about dirty bombs. They are talking about chemical weapons. And they are talking about biological weapons. And the officers and the men who will be leaving these academies should be acquainted with these. They should be trained as to how to deal with the offenses which will be committed by the offenders, not with the usual equipments and the weapons that they have at their disposal, but visualize into the future as to how these kinds of offenses have to be dealt with. Cyber crime, biological crime, bacteriological crime, and maybe radiological crime also. Your courses should have the lessons which can equip the trainees in these areas. And this is not going to stop there. You shall have to go a few steps ahead after that also. That would be required. Now, that kind of curriculum is required for your academy. These days, people have been talking about not so much about law and order, but about internal security and the terrorist activities. For your information, I would like to say that terrorist activity in Jammu and Kashmir has come down like that. More than 60% of the infiltration has come down. Nearly 40% of the casualties, there is a decline in the casualty to the extent of 40%. That doesn't mean that the terrorism has come to an end in Jammu and Kashmir, but it has declined. The same is the case in the northeastern states also. In some states, the decline is to the extent of 40, 30 or 20%. Now if you talk about the Naxalite activities in some state, in that area also, there has been a decline. It is not very impressive decline, but there has been a decline. To the percent of 1% or 0.4% decline is there. But the Naxalite activities decline is not very impressive. But the trend is that there is a decline, and we are going to treat with these kinds of activities with determination and compassion. We will deal with them, with determination as well as compassion. And I have no doubt in my mind that these activities also will be resolved. Whenever I go, political, social justice will be done. Employment will be provided. This will be the elements in the compassionate part of our dealing with this issue. At the same time, we would like to strengthen the state police and paramilitary forces and other armed forces also to deal with it. And we are going to do that. But they say, are you able to sleep in the night time with all these things happening? And I very humbly tell them, with humiliation I tell them that, look, I don't think that our country, our forces, our people are so weak that they will not be able to handle this situation. You just consider the different aspects relating to this. In my opinion, 95% of the people in our country are peaceful. 95, more than 95% of the people are peace loving. Have you applied your mind to this aspect? When 95% of the people are going to stand by you, going to see that the peace is maintained, tranquility is maintained, should we treat this problem as something which cannot be properly handled? Then what is the strength of the people who are trying to create problem? It is in thousands. Maybe they are in thousands in the country. But thousands in a country is nothing compared to crores that we have in our country. And the strength of our armed forces, state police, paramilitary forces and other forces is also quite big, and that is going to help you to maintain this. So please don't lose heart. Compassionate you should be while dealing with them. Deal with them as if they are members of your family, your brothers and sisters. But don't lose heart and don't feel dejected by seeing or reading something which is happening somewhere in our country. It is happening. It should not happen. It is happening in India. It is happening in other countries also. We know the most advanced countries also. It's happening in the countries which are very supposed to be very strong from the armed point of view. And yet these things are happening. Now you will lose this battle if you lose confidence in yourself. Situation is not such that you are required to lose confidence in yourself. Situation is such that you are strong enough and compassionate enough. I am repeating it. Strong enough and compassionate enough to deal with this situation in a proper manner, in a just manner. We don't want to kill persons. We want to kill that element in the personality or in the society which creates criminals or which creates the crime. We don't want to kill anybody, we don't want to punish anybody. We want to reform and we want to control the unruly elements in the human mind and in the society. Now this is our approach. So those who are in uniform, and those who know that they have to be ready to do any sacrifice in order to see that the entire society enjoys peace and tranquility and sleeps quietly in the night should not have wrong impressions about your own strength, about the strength of your own government, about the strength of your own people. And I would go a step ahead and say about the strength of the divinity in the human being. That divinity in the human being is real, your strength and your willingness to face any danger in order to see that the others are protected is your own strength. Not the weapons that you strength from inside is built in you, you will be real conquerors. Whatever you do, and whatever may happen to you or to others, you will be the real conquerors. And I hope that when you leave this academy, you will be determined citizens of India, determined officers and men and women who will protect the innocent people, their properties, their limbs and their lives, and you would help the society and the government and the country to have peace and tranquility, law and order and internal security provided to one another. I don't think I should have to say anything more than this. I wish you all the best. I wish this academy all the best. And I promise that whatever can be done, whatever is required to be done for this academy from Government of India side, from Delhi, and for you, who would be doing your duties in different parts of this state and maybe in other states also, we will not fail in doing that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your words of appreciation, encouragement, wisdom, advice, compassion, determination. For a long time to come, your words will reverberate in our ears. It will sound strong and true. Every time we are called upon to defend human dignity in diverse circumstances in which we are called upon to perform. Thank you very much, sir. This visit we will long cherish and remember. This has been a singular honor, matter of great pride for all of us in Kerala Presidency. On behalf of Kerala Presidency, I now request the Honorable Director of Police Kerala, Sri Raman Srivastava, to present a memento to the Honorable Union Home Minister, Sri Sivaraj Patil, to remember us during the years to come. Thank you, sir.
அதே மாதிரி வருது
இல்லை
அதெல்லாம் அதெல்லாம்
ஓகே.